Viet Cong Guerrilla, the Vietnam War. The Viet Cong were the evolution of the communist Viet Minh guerrillas during the First Indochina War against the French. The country split into the communist-ruled North and the U.S.-backed South under Ngo Dinh Diem. As it became apparent, Diem's government was unpopular. The North Vietnamese government sent former Viet Minh guerrillas to the South along the Ho Chi Minh Trail to aid the struggle for a unified communist Vietnam. These cadres made contact with villagers and talked to the locals in order to gain support for their cause. In 1960, the National Liberation Front set up as a part of the political arm of the guerrilla movement, calling for the southern Vietnamese to overthrow the camouflage colonial regime of the American imperialists. These cadres recruited guerrilla soldiers from support of local people they found, or in some cases, recruited at gunpoint. The main full-time guerrillas were trained at bases, ready for full-scale combat, while the part-time guerrillas would remain in the villages as militia with basic training. They would provide intel and set booby traps around the perimeter. The Viet Cong guerrilla wore a floppy jungle hat, rubber sandals, and a tunic. Some of the weapons they used were the Soviet SKS carbine semi-automatic rifle, the Soviet 7.62mm AK-47 assault rifle, or its Chinese copy, the Type 56 assault rifle, RPGs, grenades, landmines, and other booby traps. The Viet Cong would raid villages and eliminate government-appointed village leaders. They would ambush the enemy on roads and launch attacks on U.S. military advisors. When the United States sent in its armed forces to prevent the fall of South Vietnam to communist forces, it found the Viet Cong to be a difficult foe. The Viet Cong carried out ambushes and laid booby traps while engaging in close combat firefights to prevent the use of air support by U.S. forces. The Viet Cong guerrilla, meanwhile, in addition to combat with U.S. ground forces, had to endure bombing, napalm, and heavy armed enemy aircraft and helicopters. They also had to endure poisonous reptiles and malaria, as well as starvation. Many Viet Cong would hide from the enemy in tunnels which contained kitchens, a hospital, and sleeping quarters. During the Tet Offensive in 1968, the Viet Cong took advantage of the fact that South Vietnamese soldiers would be on leave, concealing themselves among civilians returning home. They occupied cities across South Vietnam, even occupying the capital, Saigon, and demoralizing American morale to continue in the war.
Subscribe to see more history videos. Get Symbol History, the Vietnam War, out today.
Thank you for all your support on the Symbol History YouTube channel. If you enjoy the channel, please consider supporting us at Patreon.